Good Monday evening and welcome to the NCW Life Evening News. I'm Grant Olson. Before we get to tonight's top stories, let's take a look outside our weather window on this day after Easter. Hope you all had a great Easter. And yeah, it's been a cloudy one with some rain showers that moved in after lunchtime and seen some steady rain off and on throughout our afternoon. Some areas a little bit heavier rain than others. Also some snow in the higher elevations, but not so much down here at the valley floor. As we take a look at our 7-day cold stretch of April, April 10th through the 16th, we broke a record here in Wenatchee. We're the second one from the top there, 36.3 degrees. That's 14 degrees below where we should be. And that breaks our old record set back in 1959. But we're going to stay cool as we make our way through the week. It will finally warm up as we get into the weekend, but we're seeing that rain today. A bit of a break tomorrow. More rain in our forecast Wednesday before things slowly improve, as I mentioned, as we get into the upcoming weekend. We'll talk more weather coming up a little bit later on. Now, a few of the news stories we're following for you tonight. A man was struck and killed early Sunday morning while walking on Highway 28 south of East Wenatchee, and the 28-year-old driver of the car was later arrested for felony hit and run. East Wenatchee police got help from the Columbia River Drug Task Force and the U.S. Marshals Service on Friday, and what they said was a high-risk arrest of two juvenile robbery suspects. And starting today, both the Eastmont and Wenatchee school districts have new dress codes in place aiming to tamp down on what it says is, quote, an escalation of gang-related behaviors. But first, our top story tonight. A 70-year-old Okanagan man was arrested Saturday for first-degree murder and the death of a 46-year-old Oroville woman. The Okanagan County Sheriff's Office said the two had been in a dating relationship. Sheriff's deputies responded about 8:16 p.m. to a reported domestic dispute at a home on Westlake Road in Oroville. Inside the residence was the body of Siri Zosel and two men, the sheriff's office reported. Arrested in her death was Roy Rasmussen, whom the sheriff's office said later confessed to killing Zosel. The sheriff's office said a friend of the deceased woman said she hadn't heard from Zosel and became concerned and went to the residence. The friend said after Rasmussen refused to let her talk to Zosel, he returned to the residence and Zosel found Zosel lying on the floor. He reportedly was told by Rasmussen that Zosel had been dead for about 2 days. A man was struck and killed Sunday morning, while walking on Highway 28 south of East Wenatchee, and the 28-year-old driver of the car was later arrested for felony hit and run. Arrested was Thomas A. O'Connell of Leavenworth. The Washington State Police said he left the scene of the accident but was located about 50 minutes later, several miles away on Cascade Avenue near the Otobashan Bridge, where his 2003 BMW had broken down. The hit and run happened about 5:45 a.m. on Highway 28 near South Tyee Avenue. Trooper John Bryant said the Washington State Patrol continues to investigate, and it's not yet clear if the man was walking on the shoulder of the highway or on the roadway. He said they have not yet been able to identify the victim. East Wenatchee police got help from the Columbia River Drug Task Force and the U.S. Marshals Service on Friday in what they said was a high-risk arrest of two juvenile robbery suspects. The juveniles, one age 15 from East Wenatchee, the other age 16 from Rock Island, were arrested near Eastmont Community Park. Both are charged in Douglas County with two counts of first-degree robbery and two counts of unlawful firearm possession. They were allegedly involved in a gang-related robbery of two other teens on April 1st. During that arrest, police allegedly found another 17-year-old East Wenatchee suspect carrying a stolen 9mm handgun. Information leading to the arrest came from an investigation at Eastmont Schools carried out by Resource Officer Ivy Jacobson of the East Wenatchee Police Department. Chief Rick Johnson says the investigation is still ongoing. Well, speaking of gangs, starting today, both the Eastmont and Wenatchee school districts have new dress codes in place aiming to tamp down on what it says is, quote, an escalation of gang-related behaviors. Superintendent Garn Christensen and East Wenatchee Police Chief Rick Johnson issued a joint statement on Friday with a list of clothing and accessories the district will now forbid for students at Eastmont schools and events. Wenatchee followed suit a few hours later. Those lists include hanging belts, bandanas, hairnets, hats, hoods, visible wearing of rosaries, and sports apparel for six pro sports team, which might be used to signal gang affiliation. Both districts say gang activity has permeated schools down to the upper elementary level. Eastmont plans to assemble a parent advisory committee to address the situation, and Wenatchee will hold a community meeting coming up on May 4th. Well, when we come back, the Chelan County Sheriff's Office said a scam calls on a business recently received doesn't appear to have any purpose other than to, quote, scare the heck out of the business employees, unquote. Firefighters use an inflatable boat to rescue two people who got stuck on a sandbar last week on Porter's Pond in East Wenatchee. The woman now in charge of risk management for Douglas County will become its overall county administrator later this year. And PUD Commissioner Gary Arsenault will lead the State Association of Public Utility Districts for the next year. I'm Grant Olson, and you're watching the NCW Life Evening News.
Right now is the best time to buy an RV.
And the best place is Clickit RV in Moses Lake.
I drive a Clickit RV.
Right now, Clickit RV has spring discounts to deliver you unbeatable savings. On travel trailers, fifth wheels, toy haulers, Class A or C motorhomes, both new and used, and more. Get the best deals and the lowest financing and the lowest price guaranteed.
I'm Richard Sherman, and we guarantee it.
So don't miss the spring sale in Moses Lake.
Get to Clickit RV now. Are you going to be mad, bro? You probably already are.
And check out all four Clickit RV dealerships for your best locations.
Do you have old or unused prescription medications lying around? You can now safely and anonymously dispose of them at a safe medication return kiosk near you. Just visit your nearest location. 75% of opioid misuse starts when someone uses medication that wasn't prescribed for them. By removing unwanted prescriptions from your home, you're helping to keep your loved ones safe and healthy.
It's gone on 4 decades of doing business in the Wenatchee Valley. And I want people to know that it matters. It matters to me that people choose to do business with us. It matters that people trust us. You know? Trust us. That matters more than anything.
Welcome back. In other news, the Chelan County Sheriff's Office said a scam call a business recently received doesn't appear to have any purpose other than to, quote, scare the heck out of the business employees, unquote. The Sheriff's Office said Saturday that a caller to a business claimed they were with a Mexican cartel and were in the parking lot outside with someone who had a gunshot wound. The caller first demanded medical supplies, then that the business empty their cash registers and meet someone at the local grocery store. The sheriff's office said the caller, using a fraudulent out-of-state phone number, then threatened to shoot up the business and kill everyone inside if their demands weren't met. After a search of the area, deputies determined the threats were unfounded. Firefighters use an inflatable boat to rescue two people who got stuck on a sandbar last week on Porter's Pond in East Wenatchee. Douglas County Fire District 2 received a call just before 8 p.m. Thursday that the water on the Columbia River Inlet off the Apple Capitol Loop Trail had apparently shifted, stranding the two women who had walked onto the sandbar. District spokeswoman Kay McKellar said 4 units from the fire district responded, as did the Douglas County Sheriff's Office and Ballard Ambulance, she said. Using the inflatable boat, the women were rescued and back safely on shore just before 9 p.m. Luckily, there were no injuries. The woman now in charge of risk management for Douglas County will become its overall county administrator later this year. Jordan Giulio, who worked for the county as risk manager and public information officer since 2015, was named Friday to replace Jim Barker, who will retire this winter. She previously worked as a contractor to the U.S. Department of Energy. Mark Straub, chairman of the Douglas County Board of Commissioners, said Giulio was selected from several qualified candidates for her diverse background and experiences. Well, PUD Commissioner Gary Arsenault will lead the State Association of Public Utility Districts for the next year. Arsenault, who's served on the Chelan County Utilities Board since 2015, was named president at the association's annual meeting. He joins a leadership team that already features Douglas County PUD Commissioner Ron Skagen, who's in the middle of a two-year term as treasurer. The Washington Public Utility Districts Association represents 27 publicly owned utility services from around the state. You're watching the NCW Life Evening News. Coming up next, tonight's feature story and your complete local weather forecast. That and much more still to come on the NCW Life Evening News. Please stay with us.
I'm John Divis from Wenatchee Dental Arts, and I like to think myself as a comprehensive dentist. We are an office that treats people comprehensively for their dental problems. We do a lot of general dentistry in a broad sense. We don't send everything out. Things that we have the ability to do in the office, we like to keep in the office and under one roof and keep things as complication-free as possible. You can come to one place and have all their dental needs taken care of.
Don't miss the 2022 Lake Chelan Wine and Jazz Festival. You'll enjoy a wide variety of jazz, breathtaking lake and vineyard views, and fabulous wine. The festival features 50 shows at 14 wineries and venues over 4 days. Imagine a musical tour around the beautiful Lake Chelan Wine Valley. Grab your friends and get your tickets to the 2022 Lake Chelan Wine and Jazz Festival, May 19th through the 22nd.
Introducing Alpine Airman. Because every home needs a superhero to eliminate poor indoor air quality, send inefficient operating equipment packing, and cut high energy bills down to size. For heating or cooling and equipment replacement, turn to the experts and the superheroes at Carrier and Alpine Air. We offer the best deals on high-efficiency Carrier products, along with friendly, knowledgeable service and incredible savings to fit your budget.
Welcome back to the NCW Life Evening News. In tonight's feature story, the City of Wenatchee will produce a set of short video commercials seeking to recruit new police officers. The City Council approved the $28,000 contract on Thursday, with Police Chief Steve Crown saying his department has 4 available police slots with more positions soon to come open due to retirement.
Basically, entering into a contract for North 40 to build a recruitment video that is about 3 minutes long, followed by 4 additional 30-second to 60-second videos featuring our officers. The longer recruitment video will feature the City of Wenatchee, some of its aesthetics, as well as the police department and staff doing their job.
And continuing to recruit and compete against other law enforcement agencies, not only throughout the area, but the Western U.S. and
right. Yep, and we continue to have some retirements that are trickling in on a regular basis. I'd say in the next 4 years, we're probably going to have at least 4 retirements in that time frame. So
it's a trend right now with law enforcement to pay additional incentives to recruit. So I like this idea because I believe we have something here in Wenatchee to show off, and we don't have to, even if we recruit, this video will last 4 or 5 years probably, right?
Yep.
So if we can recruit a few officers this direction, I think they would be here for a long time.
Any of our folks that have actually recruited officers to our department will say that the ride-along is the biggest sell, is being able to interact with our existing officers and the sell factor of being able to go snow skiing and literally within 15 minutes be down looking at the water and, mm-hmm. and thinking about summer and spring where you can do some water skiing and fishing.
And it's not unusual, you know, Rivercom did a recruitment video that you can see on TV from time to time and at the movie theater and other places. So it's not an unusual thing for these recruitment videos to take place and for us to get them out where potential new officers can see them.
Time now to take a look at your North Central Washington weather forecast. Hope you had a great Easter weekend. Weather, not so great Saturday, but it wasn't bad yesterday. Actually, a pretty nice afternoon. Today, the clouds rolled in. We talked about it Friday that today would be a wet one, and it turned out that way, especially this afternoon. 46 our unofficial high temperature today, and that still is well below where we should be. Our normal high now is at 63 degrees, record 83 back in 1994. Low temperature this morning, 39, pretty much right on the mark for where we should be at 41. 31 is our record low, and that was in 1987. No, we've seen a trace now. We might jump that up to 100 or 200ths of an inch so far this afternoon, but we're still just under 3 inches of moisture total since January 1st. Sunrise 6:06, sun sets tonight at 8:05. Let's take a look now. What we can expect quickly as we get you into your Tuesday weather forecast, temperatures will begin to warm up. Tuesday, kind of a transition day. We'll see temperatures mainly in the mid-50s in the Columbia Basin, 56 for Moses Lake and Ephrata, 54 degrees the high in Wenatchee, 53 in Cashmere, and 54 the high temperature tomorrow in Eniat. Tonight, we can expect still some showers. Three areas of low pressure dot the Pacific Northwest. This is the one that's moving through and will bring some showers back our direction. Lots of snow up in the Canadian Rockies as we move into tomorrow morning. For Tuesday then, partly cloudy skies, still might catch a little bit of that shower activity. Not bad tomorrow though, warmer with highs in the mid-50s. For Wednesday, as we get you to midweek, cloudy skies, large area of low pressure will begin to take shape, and that'll bring clouds and moisture up our way. This is what we can expect early in the day, and as we make our way in the afternoon, most of the shower should be in the Spokane area and down in the Palouse, but still, shower activity as we get you into Thursday night or Thursday morning as well. That should be mainly a commute shower activity with Thursday high temperatures in the mid-50s, so partly cloudy by Thursday afternoon. Partly cloudy for Friday, too, to end our work week, and warmer. We're finally going to get back closer to normal with highs on Friday in the upper 50s. We'd like to see that yellowish color, and that indicates 60-degree temperatures, and we will see that as we get into Saturday. Mostly sunny, pretty much a quiet western U.S. for once. We'll see highs on Saturday right near that 60-degree mark, so I hope you have some outdoor plans this weekend because just as nice on Sunday. Mostly sunny. We'll call it seasonal high temperatures, maybe a few high clouds in the afternoon with high temperatures on Sunday, once again near 60 degrees. Let's take a look at that 7-day forecast. 31 tonight, 54 tomorrow. Keep in mind, just isolated showers for Tuesday. Rain then likely for Wednesday will cool back down a bit to 51. And then after some morning rain Thursday, things quiet down for us as we get into Friday, 59 for Friday, and look at all that sun for the weekend. Mostly sunny on both Saturday and Sunday with high temperatures near 60. And that's a look at your local weather forecast. Coming up next, tonight's sports report with Eric Granstrom and more as the NCW Life Evening News continues right after this.
Hello, my name is Brian Brett, the Fire Chief for Chelan County Fire District 1, and I just wanted to talk about how amazing our Rivercom team is. They are intentional, purposeful, and skillful in everything they do, and they are the best at what they do. How they prepare, how they handle the caller, how they coordinate the emergency services, and how they push themselves to be the best. This is the kind of spirit that our Rivercom telecommunicators have. Our community needs you, we need you, we admire you. You're our lifeline.
It has really been a great partnership between Succession and NCWLIFE. It's not always easy to sit in front of a camera or a microphone, but you guys have made it a really nice process.
And now it's a sports update on the NCWLIFE channel.
And a happy Monday. Hope you had a good Easter weekend. The Mariners were able to put bookend wins around Hall of Fame performance by Justin Verlander and took 2 of 3 from the Astros over the weekend. After winning 11-1 on opening night Friday, Verlander pitched 8 brilliant innings Saturday for a 4-0 win. Seattle won the rubber match yesterday 7-2 behind some nifty pitching from rookie Matt Brash and a big 5-run bottom of the fourth.
Cracked into center field for a base hit. Torrens around third. He's coming home to score. Kelnick slides into third base. Julio Rodriguez has made it a 2-0 Mariners lead in the fourth inning.
First big league ribby for Julio.
Frazier sends this into center field. Kelnick trots home and scores easily. Julio into second. Adam Frazier just continues to spray line drives. He's given the Mariners a 3-0 lead in the bottom of the fourth.
And the 4-3 put out, it was 1-11.
France, a shot to center. Siri drifting. Siri watching. Gone! Home run tie, France! He has blown it open in the fourth inning. A 3-run bomb.
As Brash, last year, the minors, 19 starts. He was fantastic.
Yeah, he really was. And welcome to the major leagues last week against the Chicago White Sox. He was so impressive.
Runner taken off. Bradley after the strikeout to tag. And they got him. How about a strike him out? To begin the day.
Count. On the ground, Crawford. JP, a little flip to Frazier. All kinds of time. And a double play. Wipes away the leadoff walk. Two gone.
Well, this definitely helps when you're trying to get settled in.
Altuve to Crawford. JP on to Frazier to first base. In time, it's another double play. JP's been wearing the magnet out there at shortstop.
Really has, man. This ground ball from Matt Brash, we're seeing a few of these now, bailing him out in big situations. The Houston Astros uncharacteristically jumping on first pitches in at-bats when they're putting him on the ropes. Huge help.
Brash gets him upstairs at 95. Brantley strikes out. And Matt Brash faces the minimum in a scoreless third. How about another? Crawford, Frazier on to first. Just like they dialed it up. It's this easy. Matt Brash gets another double play. And he faces the minimum in the fourth. Swing and a miss. Brash racks up a strikeout. It's his third.
That's a big strikeout for Matt Brash. Big moment in this game.
His 0-2.
He got him. That is pure filth. Brash strikes out Jose Siri. His fourth strikeout on the afternoon. Scoreless.
The 0-2.
He got him on 3 pitches. Top shelf. 5 strikeouts for Matt Brash.
Yeah, that's some pretty good stuff right there. Manager Scott Service happy with the defense, timely hitting, and the pitching performance of Brash earning his first major league win.
You know, his stuff is just electric. Commanding it and getting in good rhythm and controlling the strike zone with it, a little bit of a challenge. But when you're that talented, sometimes you get away with it. And it's a grind. You know, we knew going into the game that Houston was probably going to be a little bit more patient against him, which they were. But credit to him. He got some, made some big pitches when he had to. We played really good defense behind him today. And, you know, we got some big 2-out hits to kind of put the 5 spot up there, you know, capped off with Ty's home run. But a lot of positive things today offensively. I thought, you know, Kelnick, good day. Julio on some things. You know, Toro starting to straighten things out a little bit there. And, yeah, it's that's what it's going to take, you know, to put big innings up. And that's what you need to do to beat these type of teams. So win the series. First series we won this year. So I need to keep that train rolling.
Seattle's off today before hosting Texas, that is, for the first of 3 games tomorrow night at 6:40. You can watch that on Root Sports Northwest. Well, busy sports day in Seattle on Saturday. The Mariners playing at Soto. Kraken playing at Climate Pledge Arena. Seattle fell behind early to the visiting New Jersey Devils, but were able to come back and earn a 4-3 win in a shootout. The game featured the first NHL goal by rookie Matty Berniers.
It's now Pullman to the side. It's wrapped. Morgan scores! Will Morgan with a bomb! Now Zaka. Boquist scores! scores Jesper Boqvist. Unmarked, all alone in front. McCann, here's a chance. They score! The deuce by the Seuss. 4:40 left in the second. Seattle has tied it. Win for the Kraken. Here's Dunn with a shot. Body down. They score! Slam time! Now McLeod, but then again it goes back door and they score. Damon Severson on the weak side. Here he comes. Donato having a career season with 15 goals. Makes it look easy. What a move by Ryan Donato. Yegor Sharangovich. Third chance on Grubauer. Right off the middle, that's Kraken hockey, baby! The Seattle Kraken defeat the New Jersey Devils in the shootout.
Seattle hosts the Ottawa Senators tonight, 7 o'clock on Root Sports Northwest. So let's check the Les Schwab Prep Baseball scoreboard from the weekend. We'll start off on Friday. Just a couple of games to report. Moses Lake swept a pair from Davis, 16-4 and 15-3, to remain atop the Big Nine standings. On Saturday, Eastmont completed a three-game sweep of Wenatchee, this time in Quincy by downing the Panthers in both ends of a doubleheader, 7-1 and 11-10. Ephrata swept Grandview in CWAC play. In Caribou Trail League action, Cashmere and Cascade split Twinville, with the Bulldogs taking the opener 24-19, while the Kodiaks came back, took the nightcap 11-1. Chelan swept two from Quincy, 4-2 and 12-2. For the smaller schools on Saturday, Brewster swept two from Okanagan. Tenasket split with Lake Roosevelt. They won the opener and then dropped the nightcap. Liberty Bells scored 68 runs and two wins over Oroville. Ouch. Waterville Mansfield swept two games from Bridgeport, 7-3 and 21-11. And Riverside Christian swept a Twinville from Patera, 16-3 and 18-8. We only had one score from Friday in Moses Lake's doubleheader. It was scheduled to be a doubleheader. We only got one score out of it on Friday with Davis. Chiefs came out on top of the Pirates by a final of 21-3. Turning to Saturday, Eastmont dominated its Cross River rival Wenatchee in a doubleheader played in Quincy, 12-0 and 11-0. Cashmere edged Cascade in a single game, 6-4. Colville swept OMAC. For the smaller schools on the Les Schwab fast pitch softball scoreboard from Saturday, Okanagan swept Brewster 15-1 and 13-0. Oroville and Liberty Bell split their two games. Lake Roosevelt took care of Tenasket 13-3 and 16-1. Waterville Mansfield swept Bridgeport 22-10 and 28-10, the finals in that one. Turning to the beautiful game, as our buddy Matt Wisen likes to call it, Christian Vaquero and Edgar Leon did the scoring for Eastmont Friday in Big Nine boys soccer to help the Wildcats stay atop the standings with a 3-1 win at Davis. Also, Moses Lake shut out West Valley 6-0. Brewster topped Oroville 4-3. And Cascade shut out OMAC at the Apple Bowl Friday night by a final of 4-0. Turning to Saturday, it was Bridgeport over OMAC 7-2. Ephrata edged Ellensburg 3-2. Chelan shut out Manson 3-0. And coming up this week, in fact, tomorrow night, we'll be at Eastmont's Wildcat Stadium as the Wildcats will play host to Moses Lake in Big Nine play. Sebastian Moraga will be joined by Neil Oyston with a call at 7 o'clock. That's a look at sports news. I'm Eric Grantstrom. Grant, back to you.
Thank you very much, Eric. And that's going to do it for our newscast tonight. For more on these stories and other news from around North Central Washington, you can find us on Facebook or our website at ncwlife.com. And remember, if you see news happening, we'd like to hear from you. You can send us an email at news@ncwlife.com or give us a call at 888-6295. I'm Grant Olson. Thanks for joining us and have a great night.
If it's spring sports, we've got you covered here on the NCW Life Channel. Lacrosse, soccer, baseball, softball, and racing at Wenatchee Valley Super Oval. Tune in weekly for all the action here on your local TV station, the NCW Life Channel.
Watch Vibrant Living, brought to you by the Wenatchee Valley Senior Activity Center. Find out about programs and activities for ages 50 and over, and meet amazing seniors who contribute to our community. New episodes Sundays at 1:30 p.m., replayed throughout the week on the NCW Life Channel.